Well, hello everyone. Not a lot going on tonight. I don't really have anything specific to talk about, but of course that's usually the way it always is. You guys will have to let me know how the mic sounds. I'm trying something new today. I guess I gotta turn off the audio. There we go. Charles Fish Tanks, I hope you found your shirt. Big Fly Multimedia would also like a lot of free stuff. Fish Aquarius says, why don't you do saltwater? I'm going to do saltwater in the very near future. But it is not set up yet. I was kind of disappointed by the amount of free stuff at the Chicago Aquatic Experience. They give you that bag that has basically nothing in it. Parker says, I hope I was watching Big Steen, or I was watching Big Steen as an excuse for not finishing this project tonight. Well, if he gives you any lip, just have him contact me. I'll set him straight. Susan is here from SLC Aquatics. Hello, Susan. Swag bag was nice. I got the reseller one. I didn't get the normal one, so maybe yours was better, but mine sucked. Let's talk at length about brackish. Go for it. What do you guys want to talk about besides brackish? I still haven't decided on an epistle I want. Dwayne says the swag bag from the OCA extravaganza was decent. Yeah, my grab bag only had those stupid little packets of food that you get when you buy like a hang on back filter or something dumb like that. Yep, dog's here again. Bob, can we talk about fish? We can certainly try. Normally it's you guys that derail the fish talk, so it's up to you guys. Talk about plecos. Salt is overrated. I have hair algae on my Rotala, but the Rotala is still growing quite fast. Is it okay to leave the algae on it? I mean, it's okay if it's not hurting it. If it's still growing fast, you could leave it on there, but it's pretty easy to pull off, too. Cameron says, LR Brett's dance for me, Bob. Bob, on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being Shia LaBeouf, 10 being Corey, how famous are you? Probably like negative 5. Aqua Gem says, why aren't my comments showing up on your chat? Lucas making it rain. Salt has a place and purpose. Yeah, I don't think salt is better than fresh water, and I don't think fresh is better than salt. I think they're both pretty awesome. Why does my tank get cloudy for 2 days after I feed the fish? Well, you could be overfeeding, or you could not have maybe not enough filtration. Bob, I still go with those two epistomaniacs at epistogrammaidiots.com. Yeah, I was looking at that site the other day. $1. I don't know that I know a $1 dance. Uh-oh. Lucas is feeling froggy. He must be drinking Mountain Dew tonight. Oh, Cameron, yes. I started reading your comment and then I got sidetracked by Lucas. Bob, my 20 gallon is complete. A breeding pair of Bolivian rams, 7 neons, 5 quarries, 1 a mono, and a leucistic snakeskin. That might be a bit much, but as long as you keep up on water changes, you should be good. Mr. Fish says, what's up with the money sign? Use this to start a goldfish tank? Dan, I think I'll need a lot more than $5. I was actually talking to someone about this super chat and like what I need to use it as a purpose. Like I just don't want it to, I don't know, like I think I'm gonna take everything I get from the super chat and just put it in a savings or a fund for fish trips. Like going to Peru or doing the Florida collecting trip. I think I'm just gonna set 100% of it aside for that. Charles says, Bob, is your 90 gallon a clear for life? It is a. It is not a clear for life. So, you were wondering what the dollar sign is for. That's what it's for. So Lucas Bratz can spam me a dollar. Save up enough, I'll send back the gunmetal Ryukin. Yep. How much was that fish? $150? That's how much it'll take for me to start a goldfish tank. Nathan says, what's one tank you'd love to have but can't have at the moment? That's my 240 gallon tank that's in the garage empty. That I actually have, but I can't have it because I don't have a way to get it in the house. Well, I do, but I don't have a way to, place to put it. Viking says, hey Bob, I just got a pair of Epistogramma Borelii. I'm really enjoying them. This is my first set of Epistos. Any tips on special care? Epistogrammas are really easy. If you keep the water clean and feed them, they like plants, they like hiding places. So they're just a lot of fun and super easy. Monday Night Live stream. Yes, Flynn. I used to always do them on Monday night, and then I think I missed one 2 weeks ago, and I think I missed last week because I was sick. Susan says, where do you guys go for fish conferences? So basically, I think a lot of us are going to the Chicago Aquatic Experience this year, and it's in November, so you want to look that up. That's like the big one. That's the biggest, I think. Lucas says, I just wanted to pop in and say hi and make it rain. Now back to work to try and offset that little splurge. Yeah. Well, thanks, Lucas. Definitely check out Lucas's channel, LR Brett's Aquatics, if you guys haven't. But I'm pretty sure if you're here, you know who he is. When your comments get skipped, yeah, there's a lot of comments, Aqua, but just keep doing it. I'll get to it eventually. No excuses. You stream even if you're sick. I don't. Sorry. Travis says, got myself some new fish this weekend. Lots of cool cichlids. Well, I want to know what kind you got. I think I got to go back here. Let's see. Charles says, that's actually a really smart idea to save money for Peru and whatnot. Yep, that's what I'm going to do with it, I think. Oh, Dan says 250. Oh. Yeah. It was an awesome fish. And I spent a lot of money on fish, but I don't know. Chuck wants to know if zebra danios have down-facing whiskers. I'm not sure, to be honest. Fish Tropic says, or you can have people donate to you for fish tank setup that they can't keep, but you can keep for them. I'd rather keep fish that I want to keep, though. I'm a little greedy in that sense. I've heard of the one in Chicago, anything in the south. I think the Pleco one is somewhere down south, but it's every 2 years. And I also don't remember the name of it. Maybe someone here does. Cameron says, any tips for breeding my Bolivians? They bred in the shop, but I don't know if my corys will eat the eggs. They'll probably keep the corys away if they do lay eggs. You just want to keep them well fed. High protein food. Got a new fish. H2O Plants is going to the Chicago Experience. Yeah, that's the one to go to. I'm going to that one this year for sure. Dan put a tank update with his goldfish in it. I'll have to go check that out. Hey Bob, after listening to Corey's live stream yesterday, it got me thinking about clown loaches. Would 3 be okay in a 75 gallon? You'd probably be doing all right for a while. They do get really big though. They get a lot bigger than people think. Tons of comments. Yeah, a lot of comments tonight. How many people? Oh, we're at over 100. That's why. I don't think we normally get this much on a Monday night. Maybe it's because I haven't done it in a while. Big Kush, so off topic, Greg Sage, what new with him? Does Corey have any of those goodieds? I don't know, but you sure love Greg Sage. Corey has the trout goodieds. I don't know which one you're talking about, but his trout goodieds are from Greg Sage. I don't know what's new with him because I don't talk to him though, so. Bob, I do have a question. What was the secret we missed in Ted Judy's Columbia series about breeding? I didn't watch that because I'll never keep those fish, so it didn't interest me. Oh boy, and I just skipped everyone's comments. Where was that? Oh man, I was way behind. Oh, here we go. Another great background. Yep, Brian Corcoran's Aquatics is here. Definitely check out his channel. He started live streaming. The Bearded Fish Keeper is here. I met the Bearded Fish Keeper on Sunday. That was pretty cool. Got a picture of him wearing my shirt. That's pretty neat. Watched him pick out some fish. Got some new fish. Abby's here, V-Stacked, Hammer Simpson. Anyone have luck culturing grindleworms in Eco-Earth? Hope you got yourself lots of dewormer. I've got a 10-gallon tank with 3 corydoras, 8 white clouds, and lots of plants. The plants are suffering from having zero nitrates all the time. I dose ferts. Can I add more fish to keep up? What are you using to test your nitrates? Because it's almost impossible to have zero nitrates. It is possible, but it's almost impossible. Hi, everyone. Susan says hi to everyone. Not leaving anyone out. Zach's Tank's crazy aquarium guy. Zach, you are in my video tomorrow. We're just letting you know. Bob, I think I know the pleco and corydoras ones. Do all plecos need wood to chomp on? Nope. So Fire Marshal Bill, they basically categorize as far as what plecos eat into four: carnivore, omnivore, herbivore, and wood eaters. I have a 20-gallon tank with some German blue rams. I don't know what to put in, but want a catfish. Ideally, would be like what types besides Cory catfish can I? What types besides a Cory catfish? There's some smaller plecos you could get, like the butterfly pleco would probably do well. Travis says it's a long list. Demonsoni, Afro Kobu, Afro White Top, Star Sapphire. Those are really nice. I have some of those. I'm sure you all saw. Taiwan Rocks, Z Rocks, Otter Point Peacocks, and some Calico Bushynose, and two other species of Victorians. I can't remember the names. Wow. You got a lot. And of course, I skipped everyone's comments again. Here we are. Susan just did a water change in two tanks and she's tired. What's the best food for a mono shrimp? Anything algae. Algae wafers, real algae. Not sure what happened, Kayla. So sorry about that. What happened to Kayla? Hey, Sergeant Tank, I got put in timeout on your stream before I could say goodbye. What did I do? Oh boy, Kayla always causing problems. Where was that? Oh well, I moved past it. Yeah, if you didn't see that, Sergeant Tank is live streaming too, so definitely subscribe to his channel. Getting all these places, we can pretty much go anywhere now and just talk fish with people. So many people are live streaming. It's pretty awesome. Hi, Sergeant Tank, just missed your live stream. Hey, Zach, always streaming after Ranger games. Okay, probably a glitch, no worries. there a word limit for my questions and comments? It's 200. 200, Lynn. What live plants for just plain gravel? All live plants. It depends on if you want to add fertilizers or not. If you don't want to add fertilizers, I would probably, you can plant anubias, just don't plant the rhizome. Same thing with Java fern, Java moss, any of the low light stuff. Jungle val will work. George says, nice background. Yeah, these are Gary Langai rainbow fish fry from eggs that I got. Did you catch Kyle's version of your shirt? Oh, great. I don't know. Do I want to look? Let's see. Pull this over here. I'm assuming it's on his channel. Did he delete his channel again? Kyle's Wild World. I was just looking at his channel like a week ago, and now apparently it's not on my list. H2O plant says I have zero nitrates all the time. Yeah, it's possible, especially in your tanks. Frequent water changes, drop nitrates. What do you think about ornate bikers? I like all bikers. I think they're pretty sweet. They're like old dinosaurs. Bob, how's your low boy doing? Doing great. I just added some more plecos today. You'll see that tomorrow. Sergeant Tank, I really feel bad. I couldn't watch the stream because my mom wanted me to do a personality test. Those were so dumb. I remember doing those in school. Nina says, what the background was life size. Shrimp as big as his head. Aqua Gem says, my ballasting area has taken over. Yeah, I love when it does that. Bob, does the grown man in the same room as you care that you live stream? Clearly not, otherwise he wouldn't be in here. Oh man, skipped it all again. I used to be pretty good at this, but apparently I don't do it enough anymore. Have I bought fish from Great Fish USA? Never even heard of them. Zach's Tank's Crazy Aquarium Guy says, really, why? Either way, thanks. There's no bad publicity. I'm just using your channel in my daily spotlight. I like your channel, so I'm going to tell people to check it out. Lynn says, I did a 40% water change in my 10-gallon yesterday. Today I've lost two blue-eyed yellow fork-tail rainbows and a mystery snail. Have you tested your water yet? I would test it. How come more towards the East Coast, fish keeping isn't as popular? I live in Massachusetts. Shop selection is only big chain stores. I think it's way more popular on the East Coast, but that's just me. Might just be the town that you're in. But like all the aquarium shows are either in the mid or the East Coast. I think we have like one or two in California and that's it. Lynn said I had small spike in nitrates and nitrites, which is why I did the water change. Any ideas? It's pretty hard to kill a snail, isn't it? Yeah, it is pretty hard to kill a snail. You might have lost your cycle. Did you check your ammonia? Dan says, yep, he's been doing a channel spotlight. I missed it one day because I suck. But yeah, I've been at the end of my daily videos all this month, I'm doing a channel spotlight to the channels that I watch. And I watch like 500, so I'm not going to get to everyone. So don't get mad. I'm not doing these in any type of order either. So I'm not going to be able to get to everyone, so I apologize. Don't get angry. Short and Anxious is here. What can I feed? Peaf puffers? Bloodworms. Blackworms. Hey, Short. Dank Tanks. KG. Can't happen. What a KG. What's your opinion on people that claim to cycle a tank in a week just with BB in a bottle alone? I don't necessarily believe that. So if they're doing it in a week, I think they're gonna have problems. I'm sure it can be done, but not the average person. Camera says, I love our community. It used to be so much judgment. Now everyone is so open and nice. Love all you guys and our taco union. Yep. It's definitely a lot better than some of the other communities, and even some of the other fish communities are still really bad. Bob, is this a Grimble Grumble's tank or is this someone else? I don't know. Let me check the description. Background by Grimble Grumble. Alright, to be fair, the name's not there. But yeah, I didn't have time to download and go search through my email for videos, so I'm using one I already had. I do have more to show, I just didn't have time. It's been pretty crazy around here. Some more suggestions for your pea puffers. Black worms, mosquito larvae, brine shrimp, grindle, and white worms. Blood worms, yep. Worms, worms, worms. Hey, Charles, Mark, Fish, Tropic. Hey, Fish, Tropic, and Mark. Okay. I live by live plants. I live by live plants, too. Kyle tie-dyed it? What's his channel? Can one of my moderators link his channel? Because apparently I'm not a subscriber anymore. And I just was like a week ago. That's what I'm saying. Then people come in and they're so sure that it can cycle a tank so quickly, but don't realize how much of an impact and lifespan of your fish. Yep. Aftershock Beta says, hey Bob, what program are you using to have the video layout you're using? The program I'm using for live streaming is OBS. OBS. Hey Bob, I have a potassium deficiency in my tank. What do I add to this besides banana? Seachem makes potassium fertilizer that's just potassium. Hi from England. We have an all cichlid tank. Recently added some more, but they have sunken belly. I treated the tank last Thursday, but haven't noticed a difference. Can I add more medicine? Depends on the medicine. So I should tell you. Where did that go? Looks like sashimi is here. Oh man, I'm so far behind. I feel like sashimi whiskey right now. Where did that go? Well, anyways, this is where I'm starting from because I don't know where that went. So I'm here in Jamaica and just started back to breed fish. Just started back to breed fish like guppies, mollies, swordtails, bettas, gouramis, goldfish, but I don't use any filtration or anything. Is that bad? Not if you're doing water changes. I knew I was unsocial, and that's basically what it said. how many fish do you think you have at the moment? Over 1,000? Easily, maybe two. Aquarium Co-op has a good video on cycling, seasoning. Yes. Thank you, Bob. Means a lot. Yeah. So Zach's Tanks Crazy Aquarium has some really nice planet tanks, some awesome plecos. Uh-oh, what is this? What am I opening? I hope you're not trolling me. Oh man, that looks awesome. Now I'm going to have to tie-dye one. Man, it's been so long since I've tie-dyed a shirt. Anyone that subs to me tonight will be entered into my 200 subscriber giveaway, Moonlight Moscow's Guppies, my own strain. Hit me up. So everyone who goes and subscribes tonight to Fish Tropic will have a chance at some Moonlight Moscow Guppies. Zach, is it not like 4 a.m. in Sweden right now? Go to bed. No way. Stay here. I live in Mass. My club auctions is this weekend. Tons of places in Massachusetts. I don't know. I'm originally from Kansas City. I feel like the East and West Coast have all the fish enthusiasts. Yep. Typo yo-yo up and down. Anyone know how to cat-proof a filter? Put barbed wire on it. PA Fish Preacher, what's going on, buddy? Rick Howard, a cichlid like Severum or Acara. You guys are talking about something. The only fish I can get that's not 7 hours away from me is bettas. Check out the fish bowl in Fall River, Massachusetts. Gotta stop trying to say that word. My old stomping ground. So yeah, it looks like there's some stuff there going on. Aquatazy says, to the person who lost your fish after a water change, test your tap water. Could be ammonia in the tap water. You could also have chlorine. I know that I learned when my water company doses chlorine, so I don't do any water changes for like a week after they do that. Yeah, it's told. LFS told me 3 days, but I lost most of my starter fish. Hey, Nerdy Fish, what club are you in? Get back to work, Whiskey. Yep, gotta get my video going. Bob, I sent you Kyle's Wild Worlds on your messages. Oh, you mean this message right here? All right, here we go. Now I can subscribe again, apparently. Glad that guy is back. I am. That's why I'm not talking much here. Listening to him in the video and the live stream is confusing. You're listening to me in 3D. Hey Dan, it's 4 in the morning and co-op starts. The video is at 2 a.m. Thank God I'm a night person. The Ultimate wants to know if it's bad to combine different colored Neo shrimp, cherry, yellow, blue, etc. in the same tank. That's completely up to you. Nothing. Travis Milligan stopped by. Didn't get it. And I just. Murdered everyone comments here. Okay, here we go. Travis says Sunday his dog had her puppies. That's awesome. Sashimi Whiskey, I finally fell asleep at 3:30 a.m. last night. Was it last night that I had the live stream going forever? I remember. Seachem makes pretty much everything. Yep. Wondershare for editing. That's what I use. Shortcuts on cycling are just not worth it. Yep. That's the biggest tip you can give anyone getting into the fish hobby is to be patient. I feel. I mean, that's the number one tip I would say. Well, I guess Kyle deleted all his channels. I went through all his channels he used and I can't find them. Nope. There is a channel here. I was just watching it. And I just subscribed to it. Kyle's Wild World. There you go. Blue tick coonhound puppies. I kind of want one. I'm the one with the cichlid tank with the sunken bellies. I've never heard of that medication before, but I would think on the bottle it would tell you how to dose it. I mean, right? That makes sense. But sorry, I've never heard of that. We don't have that over here. Over 9,000 species, Bob. Top three L plecos. The only one I could say for sure is that the L397 is the top three. The other two would be up for debate. What's a good background plant for a tall 60-gallon tank? I would use Jungle Val. But I kind of got, I'm on a big Jungle Val kick right now. Bob, what is Seraph mixed with? The vets are guessing she is a husky shepherd mix. German shepherd. I have a 30-gallon fish tank and all the fish and then all of a sudden grew white stuff on them that was free and all died. Can you please tell me if there's something I can do? It's on them that was free. Well, I mean, if they're all dead, there's really nothing you can do now. I would do a big water change and then probably treat it with some like antifungus medication. Heck, I'd probably treat it with everything. General cure, erythromycin, Ic-X. I'd hit the whole tank with everything. Believe I recall you saying she was mixed. Yep, Kyle still has his channel up. Just talking this afternoon. Yep, he does. Your dog needs water, Bob. She has water. Who is the dude in the room with you? He is my friend and the homeowner. There's Kyle's Wild Worlds channel. It's Amazonian coughing Paku. So how's the weather, everyone? Linked. I'm trying to get to the end. Eric says, "What's your opinion on cycling with only fish food and no livestock?" It works. That's about my only opinion. Reef and Liber Aquatics is here. All right, I think I made it to the bottom. Everyone's talking about how to cycle, how they cycle. Aftershock Beta says, "Would love to hang around, Bob, but it's been a long day. Thank you for following me on Instagram, Aftershock Aquatics, and also thank you for wondering my video software question." Anytime. I'm guess answering. David's here. What's up, David? Short and Anxious says, "I'm stressed, but good, David." It's a Monday. Short and Anxious is getting some new fish this week, I believe. Allison says, "Coon hounds are awesome dogs. Just saw the most beautiful black and tan on the dog show." Andy says, "How's that BioCube coming along?" It's coming along. It's pretty much the same as it was on Saturday in my Saturday video. Sashimi Whiskey says, "A huge Amazon box came today, and our whole house was confused on what it was because it had my name on it, but I haven't ordered anything. Turns out Corey sent me 3 cases of Mountain Dew Code Red." Abby got a snow day. Well, hey, at least he got a snow day when he stayed up till 3:30 in the morning. Short and Anxious says, "I'm getting new fish." Yep. Yep, you are. Reef, are you still singing Sweet Caroline? Sashimi Whiskey has the best boss ever. Hasting Fa, does a co-op dosing affect TDS? I would assume so. Sweet Caroline, blah blah blah. Yeah, not the good one though. Not the good version of Sweet Caroline. The crappy version. Tropical Tanker says, "Reef and Liber Aquatics, I subbed." I think that means he wants you to sub him back. What did the fish say when it hit a concrete wall? Damn. How the shrimp, Bob? Shrimp are doing great. Got lots of little baby yellow shrimps. Big J Aquatic says, "What? I did not know you're live." Well, I normally always live stream on Monday, but I missed two in a row. So I understand if you didn't know I was. It's my own fault. Andy Ray says, "I've lost a cichlid. I swear it's completely gone. Has this happened to you? I've searched the whole tank. Inside, outside filters everywhere. Probably got ate. Something probably ate it. Probably died and then got eaten. Eaten. Corey wants to make sure you're editing on point." Flynn is back. Bless you, doggy. Thinks she has a cold. What kind of rainbow fish are those? Those are Melanotania Gary Langi. It doesn't. Oh man, how many subs I have. Tropical, I'm just teasing you, buddy. Poor puppy still needs to go to the vet. I hate when I stay up all night and then the next day I have a surprise 50 question test. I don't miss those days, I'll tell you that much. Charles, fish and flora, do you have any other hobbies? Yes, that's why I can't wait for this month to be on, or this month to be over, because all my other hobbies are on complete hold right now doing these daily videos. Logo thumbnails all done, like 10 hours of work. Can't believe I'm saying this, but can we not talk about amazing dogs? I really want one and can't get one. And my friend's dog passed away today, and I knew that dog from when he was a puppy. Very cool, Gary Lang guy. Yep. Maybe one day I'll have a fish named after me, but probably not. My Siamese algae eater looks pregnant, but I haven't seen my other algae eater in a few days. Probably just really fat, hopefully not sick. Kayla, how's your ducking day? Bob, love watching your stream. I learn a lot. Thank you, sir. I'm glad you're here. LOL, David, it was ducking awesome, actually. Are we gonna have to add ducking to the things you can't say on my channel? To my spam filter list? Tropical Tanker says half term where I live, so no school tomorrow. I swear, kids get so many days off now, it's ridiculous. I'm editing a video right now, so I'll be popping in and out of the chat. Fish Beast is here. Charles says, Bob, if you had a fish named after you, it'd be Genius Steenfatai. I think there's got to be two eyes. But if I had a fish named after me, it would be called Lie. Lee. Joseph Jones says, what do I do if she is sick? Well, I'm not saying she's sick, so don't stress about it. Just watch her for a couple days, and if she's still acting normal, then I wouldn't be too worried about it. Don't worry, the live stream can start because I'm here now. Thanks, Aquarium. We were all waiting just for you. The fish beast is still at work? That sucks. Jamie wants to know, are cardinal tetras susceptible to ick more than other fish? I feel like they get ick more because they're not in the correct environment. Because they should be they should be in hot water, like warmer water, not hot. But I feel like a lot of people keep them colder than they should be, so they're probably already stressed. So ideally, a fish named after me would be a new angelfish. Of course it would, but there's never going to be any more new angelfish. Sorry. Corey is so popular, he has an entire family of catfish named after him. That's true. The Fish Life says, is it tough to breed long-finned albino bristlenose plecos? Not at all. They're almost as easy as guppies. Caroline should be writing three papers. My logo looks different on the chat on my screen. Why? Big J Aquatics. It takes like days for YouTube to update everything, I swear. Short and anxious. UPS tracking number notification just came in. She's getting her new fish shipped out tomorrow. I don't have time to edit. I have to get my footage when my little sister isn't home and disrupts the audio. Why not fish name Bob? Why not a fish named Bob? That's what I'm saying, but there's too many Bobs. Or Corey was named after the catfish. Bob, if you could genetically make any fish, what would you mash together? I would put the zebra pleco coloring on a cheap tetra so that I could get that color at a reasonable price. Jamie says, what temperature do you recommend for cardinal tetras? I've never kept them myself, but I know a lot of people, they specifically keep them with discus because they like to be in the 80s. But like I said, I've never kept them myself. Well, that's not true. Most angelfish enthusiasts agree that there's a lot, at least one other species of undescribed species of angelfish. That's too many species in one sentence. Never gonna happen. You're never gonna see another new species of angelfish. Ever. Crushing your dreams. When I woke up this morning and looked at my tank, I was so happy. Then I put some food in the tank, and 1 million little swordtails just came up right out of the plants, and then I died. What fish are you getting short? Yeah, short. Tell us what you're getting. Charles says Cardinals have done well for me in 80 to 86. Yeah, I think they really need to be in the 80s. No bobfish, but there's a blobfish. My betta is Bob. Pink fish named. Little sister named it. That's funny. How deep do you keep your val? Mine have all died. It's like, how deep do you keep them in? Do I keep them in the substrate? Or, like, how deep of a tank? Most of my substrate is about 3 inches, and I'll bury it all the way to the bottom. And it does just fine. If you're talking about depth of tank, it should grow in everything as long as there's adequate lighting, even a 4 foot tank. Charles, fish tanks, how do they know that if we don't already know about it? Steen, can I let your watchers know about my blowout sale coming Wednesday? Absolutely, buddy. H2O Plants is having a blowout sale on Wednesday. 95% off all plants. I wholeheartedly agree with your zebra pleco tetra mashup. David, well, I suck at gravel vacuuming, so my 5 gallon overflooded, and then I was putting water in the other tank, and then the filter broke and flooded the floor. Sound like LR Brett's there. The Fish Life says, I might get a tire track eel. Are they good pets? They can be kind of finicky eaters, but other than that, not so much. Speaking of Corey, that was an amazing story about the flooded store. Saw the video this morning. Awesome. Thanks for watching it. And yeah, we were just sitting there talking for a while, and I was like, you know what? I should just film us talking. I'm falling behind again. I keep both my tanks at 83 degrees and it works well. Hopefully, you're talking about Cardinal Tetras, gravel or sand as substrate. It's up to you. I have gravel and sand, so I don't prefer one over the other. It depends on what's going in it. For cichlids, I use sand. For plants, I try to use gravel. Many moons ago, I had a goldfish named Bob. I named it after my grandpap. Oh, and you too, Bob. It's lame but funny. Oh, I guess I should see if he. Oh, no. So he's not having a 95% off sale. I was just throwing him under the bus. But I haven't seen where or if he said what his sale was. So we'll look out for that. Okay, here I was. Eric, they have all died on me. That's so funny. I keep both. Bob, do you use any Eheim canister filters? Nope. I picked up a 2217 for $38 at the auction. That's a good deal. I know what it is. I don't use Eheim canister filters. And it's not because I don't like them. I've just never used one. Bob's laugh is so funny. Sounds like a car trying to start. Like a Volkswagen, probably. Like an old Volkswagen bug. Because people search through inventories of wild-caught angelfish and find distinctive characteristics in more than one individual. Check out Angels Plus website. He has a photo. He doesn't have photo of any new angelfish. I'm telling you, 90%. Yep, Jamie says 95% off and free shipping. I'm in. I don't endorse 95% off, but I will have 25 to 30% off all plants on Wednesday with free shipping. H2O, why can't you do a sale next month so I can afford plants? Maybe he will. What do you think is a good heater? I have a lot of heaters that I've gotten for free. If I had to buy a heater, I think the only one I would buy is the Aquion Pro. Oh man, skipping everything again here. I've had people offer 150 forum. Okay, you guys are talking about something, I don't know. Bob, sing my baby to sleep, please. You don't want me singing her. That baby's gonna be up crying all night. Give it up, Charles. He's just breaking your mineral balls. Yeah. See, Charles loves Angelfish so much that even though he knows I'm just busting his balls, he still has to go on with it. Yes, fish life starting Wednesday, lasting to Saturday. Very limited stock. My guppies got out of hand around 2 years ago. I had over 150 and it was hard to sell them as they took over the tank and I couldn't keep up with the water changes. Now I do selective breeding and sell. Jamie, yes, I have heat packs available. Dude, why Aquion Pro? Is it because of the plastic housing? I'm going Aquion Pro just from other fish keepers I follow speaking nothing but good things about them. I've made Charles pull out the big guns, except I don't care, so I'm not gonna click on the article. Bob is angelfish. How many angelfish would you put in a 30-gallon tank? I would probably just do a pair. Where can I buy rainbow fish? I love them and they look so cool. I have nowhere close to me that sells them, but they are really, is there a really good place I can buy from? If you're gonna buy online, look at aquabid.com or the Wet Spot Tropical Fish. H2O, are you going to sell more stuff on the website for the sale, or is it stock you already have? H2O, can I order from a website or a Facebook page? Pretty sure he has a website. Stamps, I have a bunch of stock. Charles, 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 big guns. I just spilled my water a little bit. The fact that he just said, Bob, you have learned that from me. What? That fact you just said. I don't even know what I just said. Jamie, the website, but follow me on Facebook or Instagram so you get notified when the sale goes live. What's the website, though? Quirma Cichlid says, have you gotten that rusty cichlid eggs? Nope, when she gets closer to spitting, I might remove her. But I'm not gonna strip her, I'm just gonna let her spit. I might move her into a 10-gallon tank or something. And how are those two cichlids in the tank? Any sign of fry? Oh, the Neolamprologus. No, most of the eggs got eaten. I shined a flashlight in the cichlid stone, and there was like maybe 10 eggs left, so she's not doing a very good job protecting them. Bob, why are you skipping the great sale? Why are you skipping the great sale you offered? Why am I skipping? I don't know what you're talking about, Bob. I see that the troll side of you, the force is strong. What is the ideal phosphate level in the planted tank? I think that's a tough tough question to answer. It kind of depends on your plans. 100% off plus free shipping. I'll do 95% off in free shipping on my website. All items on my website, 95% off and free shipping. Sashimi Whiskey says, Flynn's Fish Forum. I sent you a Facebook request. I'm gonna ask you some questions. Aquarium of Cichlids. Is Corey with him? There you go. www.h2oplants.com. Sale starting Wednesday. I got my rainbows from Imperial Tropical. Yeah, Imperial Tropical has good good fish, and it's free shipping on orders over $45, I think. So that's a pretty sweet deal. Charles Fish and Flora says, what species is that lonely Cypricromis with the grow outs? That's the problem, is I have no idea what she is, so I cannot mix her with any of my other Cypricromis. Please check out my channel and please subscribe. That made it sound like I was saying that about my channel. I like it. Yeah, Charles, since she is just a gray female, I have no way of knowing what type of Cyperchroma she is. That's why she is forever alone. So Shimmy, you told me that you use Sony Vegas to edit, but which Sony Vegas? There's different ones. Sweet Caroline, I use Sony Vegas Pro 13. Kayla got the website up there. I guess I could have not been lazy and just typed it there too. Oh well, that's why I have mods, right? She's earning her modship. Okay, let's see what we're looking at here. Wow, there's almost as many people here tonight as there is on Saturday. That's crazy. Me driving jokes in the ground since forever. Is that a coffin? I think that's a coffin. Yes, Joseph, they do need CO2. Reading an article about low temperature induced bone shrinkage for my paper and listening to the live stream. I think there's an episode of Seinfeld that talks about low temperature and shrinkage. I think. What fish is overpriced, Bob? I don't know. Yes, gold stars for Kayla tonight. She's moving to mod level 2. Matt DLR, it takes me so long to set up a tank and then I still need to learn how to edit better. And I don't think I can do time-lapse videos on my phone. It was fun hanging out with you guys. Gotta go. Phone is dying. Later, fish keepers. See ya, Tankhead videos. Thanks for stopping by. I was in the pool. I'm glad somebody got that reference. I bet Whiskey got it too. He seems to know every reference. Got home and had a fish stuck between glass and sponge filter. Swimming okay, ate well, but his side that was up against the sponge is pretty tore up. Debating on dosing urethro preventatively, what would you do? Allison, I would probably watch him. To me, it would depend on what other fish are in the tank. If they're peaceful fish and they're not going to pick at it, I would probably just leave it and make sure the water is nice and clean. Bob, what do you feed your rainbows? If you would talk about 2 weeks, is it Gary Lang or is it Great Food? If you would talk about 2 weeks, if you would, that's gotta be a typo, but I don't know what kind or what you're trying to say. But what do I feed my rainbows? So I feed frozen bloodworms, omega 1 flake, the aquarium co-op fry food, and do I feed them anything else right now? I think that's it right now. And for the other part of your question, maybe you're asking why they look so good. One, it's definitely because they're from Gary Lang. And I think that's a pretty high quality diet, so maybe a little of both. But definitely the Gary Lang rainbow fish look way better than any other rainbow fish I've ever seen. No Anubias needs CO2, that is certainly true. Zebra plecos are overpriced, that's why Bob wants to breed a tetra with them. Well, just because a fish is expensive doesn't mean it's overpriced. I don't think that they're overpriced. It depends. Like, obviously, if you go to Live Aquaria and they're $500, that's overpriced. But that's not the fish's fault. That's Live Aquaria. I got mine for considerably cheaper than that. Way cheaper. Have you fed your fish Rapashi food yet? Absolutely. I have 6 or 7 different types of Rapashi right now. Bob, did you say that you spent $60 on a piece of Boost? No, but I did spend $80 on a piece of Anubias. Thanks, Bob. Sorry. Yeah, I was able to decipher that after thinking about it for a second. Glowfish are overpriced. Welcome to the Twilight Zone, David. It's where you can leave and come back and nothing changes. Yeah, I think I do a care video for my swordtails next. There you go. You're definitely breeding a ton of them, so. Jacob wants to know where I get my fish. I order a lot of fish through my local fish store, and wherever they come from is wherever they get them from. I order fish from Aquabid. Sometimes I order fish from cichlidlovers.com. H2O Plant says, which Anubius is $80? Anubius pangolino. Pangolino. Do you guys hear that high screeching noise? I have no idea what that was. Let me see. Anubius pangolino. There it is. That was $80. But I also bought it on the first import to the US. So, I was special and I was one of the first people in the US to get it. That's right. It's quite a bit cheaper now. But I spent, it was $80 for a pot, I think. I think I got a pot for $80. Now you can get like, you can find them on, Aquabid for around like $20 or $30, but it's like a little itty bitty section. Susan found Liguidia repens. That's a great plant. That is a really good plant. Filthy Phil is here. What's going on, buddy? Yep, I heard the high screeching noise. Yeah, I'm the only one in the room right now except for my dog, so I don't know where that's coming from. Don't worry about the screeching, Bob. That's the alien death robot. I think he left his speakers on. Anubis Nana Pinto is $120 in Australia. I think I saw some for like $30 here. I think I even have some somewhere. No, I have Anubis Bonsai. That's what I have. Tyler's Tank says, good LED for a 10-gallon tank. I like the Fennec's Stingray. Fennec's Stingray. Minimum outside temp for a guppy tote outside. Well, I keep minus 70 degrees, but I'm sure they could go down into the 60s. David, have your daughter do a video on her tank. She's blushing. What did I miss? Aquariums on. Let's see. David's aquarium or David Beckencourt. My daughter said hi to all my fishy friends. Hello, David's daughter. If I knew your name, I would say hello to your name. I wanted a book on apistos, but it's $272 on Amazon. What about eBay? Check eBay. I can't spell today. I can't spell any day. All right, time to take a break from grading papers. How's it going, everyone? Kinkajou is here. How would you start a new tank up and get it cycled? So how I would do it is I would just take a sponge filter out of one of my already established tanks and drop it in there, and it would cycle instantly. That's how I do it. Bob, what if you got $500 over the month and do a 24-hour live stream, or do a 24-hour live stream and keep it on as long as there is 10 viewers? Well, the only reason I turned it off last night was because it got down to 7 viewers and no one was commenting. If there is more than 10, I would have kept it on. Flynn says, when you click view deleted message on a deleted message, does the message come back? Nope. Big Fly Multimedia says, are you intentionally breeding any African cichlids? I'm intentionally breeding my Paracyprochromis blue neons. Otherwise, some of my cichlids I'm growing out, I will intentionally breed, like my Copetochromis, because I love Copetochromis. I'm intentionally breeding my shell dwellers. I guess you could say intentionally breeding those. Otherwise, I don't think there's anything else I'm intentionally breeding. Tropical Tanker says it's not letting me chat. Well, it's not letting you chat. I couldn't see that. Midterm grades always sneak up on me. Just make them. Just make it up. You don't have to grade anything. You know which ones are your good students and which ones are your bad ones. Ben Real, y'all. Gotta go help a friend set up a tank tomorrow. Y'all have a blessed night. Peace out. See you, Big J. Have fun with that tomorrow. I left last night's stream when I fell asleep. I was one of those not commenting. Those blue neons are sweet. Yep. I want to get up to like 200 of them. When I get up to 200, then I'll start selling them. But not until then. Travis says, okay, guys and gals, it's been fun, but I got to go. Take care. Thanks for stopping by, Travis. Hey, how are you, Big Fly? Yeah, I use those types of speakers. Something. I'm good short, how are you? Flynn, what are your favorite and least favorite videos? Care videos, unboxing videos. I like watching Corey's unboxing videos in his store because it makes me feel like I'm getting fish, even though I know I'm not, and that's stupid, but... Bob, that is sadly true. Yep. I don't watch care videos unless I'm specifically buying that fish. So, I don't know that care videos are a good type of video. Like, if you're asking what types of videos you should do, care videos aren't really that big of a deal to me. Like I said, I only watch care videos when I'm specifically looking at a fish. So I would say care videos are probably my least favorite, and my favorite is unboxing. Would hatchets work with Shelly's? They probably would. Peace out, everyone. I gotta go do homework. See you, Nina. Why can't I scroll down? Night, Big J. What's your day job? I'm in IT. Hey, Bob, why don't you ever update Beta and Mr. Guppy? Yeah, it's been a while, actually. I think it's been like a month. Maybe I will. I got a whole month of videos to shoot, so maybe. More Danio. Of course. More Danio. I already know he's talking about short. Can you think of any top-drolling fish that can go in a quarry cat breeding tank 20 long that won't affect the breeding? It would have to be a really, really, like, nano fish. And even then, they would still might go after the eggs. Fish room tour videos. Yeah, those are some of my favorite. Have you ever kept dojo loaches? Nope. I'm keeping zebra loaches right now and hillstream loaches. I think those are the only loaches I have right now. Filthy Phil says, pygmy hatch a fish. Yeah, that's probably a good one. Charles Fish and Flora says, what types of videos would you recommend for someone starting out? I think you need to find a direction on where you want to go with your channel, and then just do that. If that makes sense. So the reason, like, I've never really done species videos or review videos is because that's not really why I'm here, so I don't do those types of videos. I just prefer to document my fish and what I do with my fish. Now, if somebody wants to ask an opinion on like a review of something, that's fine, I'll do that, but to dedicate a whole video to that, I'm not very passionate about that, so. Heard. Here's a fish for you, Charles Fish Tanks. I know you're still here, but Tropical Tanker would like to know how you sex angel fish. My Abby says her favorite videos are DIY updates, care videos, and unboxing videos, also different fish room videos. Do you have any issues with your rainbows jumping? Yes. Absolutely. That's why a lot of my rainbows are, if you watch my videos, some of my rainbows you'll see like their mouths will look white like it's a fungus, but it's not. That's just from them either running into decorations or jumping up at the food and hitting the lid. Okay, I'm missing a bunch of comments. I thought David was leaving. Was I wrong? Maybe I was seeing someone else. But you're still here, so that's cool. Bob, what's the ideal setting for keeping clown loaches? They always die on me. One, well, lots of room, good water quality, and lots of bloodworms. High protein. Bob, are you here to just be big and cuddly? Yep, that's me. Cooley loaches are like the cheap man's eel. That's probably pretty accurate. What's the best way? Oh, yep, Charles. Charles. Come on, Charles. You haven't answered yet. How do you sex angelfish? Aquarium of Cichlids, Bob, do you have a favorite viewer or the viewer you had the best connection with since you started? Not Corey. No, I couldn't bring it down. I mean, I couldn't even say Corey for that matter. Strictly because Corey and I were friends before YouTube, right? So we already had that connection. But to try to narrow it down would be ridiculous. There's way too many awesome people. My favorite videos are live streams. That's awesome. Mackenzie Ferguson says, what species of rainbow fish were in the turquoise? Were the turquoise blue ones in the 125 gallon that was in your fish room tour on Aquarium Co-op? So there's two of them. It could be the turquoise rainbow, which seems like an obvious answer, but there are also Kamaka rainbows in there, which is K-A-M-A-K-A rainbow. Aquarium Co-op says, we are no longer friends. Bob, did you ever see black banded rainbow fish? I've never even heard of that. I have two juvenile and not planning on breeding them, but was just wondering. Yeah, what happened to Charles, man? Oh, here we go. Tropical Tanker, it's difficult. Even when they're adults, there are some hints, but those are generally unreliable. Best way to tell is to look at the breeding tubes. Males have a thin, pointed tube. Females have a shorter, flat, and wide tube. if the clowns are small, feed them a lot. Seriously, a lot. They need to eat all the time. Yep. Lots of food. High protein food, too. Short and anxious. Haha, Corey. Bob's definitely right about the videos. I also don't like reviewing products or giving fish profiles. I just like showing everyone my tanks. Yep. You know, in some of my videos, I'll talk about a fish and like how I care for it, but that's not necessarily like a specific care video. Corey the Heartbreaker, big fly, hope you caught it in time. I almost lost my new German red peacock. He got his butt kicked. I had to move him into a different tank tonight. I hope he makes it. Yeah, that was a good looking fish too. Sup all, hey Bob, how was your weekend? My weekend was absolutely chaotic. It was ridiculous. I'm glad it's over. It was chaotic in a good way. There was just a ton of stuff I had to do this weekend. Well, everyone, since Corey and Bob split, welcome to the 2017 Hunger Games. Winner takes Corey's place. I think it will be okay, Mark. Big Fly says, I think it will be okay. A little tore up, but still swimming. That's good. As long as he's swimming and eating, it's usually a good sign. Crystal Ball says, completely off subject, but I watched vlog number 4 by Lucas. The intro was hilarious. Hopefully Dustin doesn't have a hissy fit. I don't know. I've been waiting for that one to come out. I might have to watch it right now. Let's go. I'm still on Kyle's channel. Let's go to Lucas. Bring the browser over here. We're taking a timeout. Hold the phone, guys. I'm going to watch Lucas's video. Because this is the second time I've heard about this. Man, I'm missing a couple of channels here. What's going on, YouTube? Vlog number 4.
bring it to you on some day of the week. Sometimes shoot take people, lrbaquatic.com, LR Bread Aquatics, bring it to you on some day of the week. Today we're going to do vlog number 4.
Oh man, that guy's crazy. I love it. You guys need to go check out Lucas's video that he released yesterday, vlog number 4. Oh man. I gotta turn my speakers back down. Boy, I missed a lot of stuff. Charles Fishang says, the one exception video I may make in the future is one that goes over how to tell the difference between the 3 described species of angelfish, and then going over the possible 4 species with which will never be found and does not exist. Par meter is an apogee par meter. My energy is restored slightly. I think there is a leak. What did I miss? Do you guys know what? Yep, there it is. Completely off subject. Oh, I wasn't that far behind. I'll wrap my sleep schedule. Time to go to bed. Thanks for stopping by, Caroline. Bob, have you ever seen checkered rainbow fish? Nope, never heard of them. You guys have crazy names for rainbow fish. Hey Bob, does Seachem Stability really work, or is it snake oil? I think they're all snake oil. Every single one of them. Bob, have you owned or own the orange Parkinson's rainbow? They do. Do they have all those markings? If you watch my videos, you would know that I do have Parkinson's rainbow fish. Come on, Kayla, you just got demoted. You worked up to mod rank 2, but now you're back to mod rank 1. Hi, I'm new on here. First time ever, but seeing you on Corey's video. Awesome. Big Fly is out of here. He's got to get up at 5 a.m. Thanks for stopping by, Lon. Really appreciate it. LR Brett's info, intro. Yeah. That's funny. Bob, I hate to tell you this, but the entire genius of Cyprochromis doesn't exist. They're just a figment of your imagination. Well, then I have an amazing imagination. Tropical Tanker says, I bought 6 GBR thinking there must be a breeding pair in there. Nope, all 6 are female. All my LFS has stopped selling them, so I'm stuck with 6 female. That kind of sucks. That's like when I bought my 6 Epicigramma Orange Flash. Wasn't that bad, but I ended up with 5 males. And they all ended up being terrible. They looked really bad. You'll see it. You'll see the one I kept tomorrow, and it looks terrible. Aquarium of Cichlids. So, Bob, am I a level 2 viewer? I don't know that there's levels for viewers. I haven't thought that much into it yet. Chameleon Gaming says, what strain of guppies do you breed for profit? They're Red Delta. Red Delta guppies. Starting to prep work on my new fish rack this weekend. That'll be fun. Frowny face. I think that would be fun. That deserves a smiley face. How much supplemental feeding do you do for your breeding bristlenose? Supplemental? I mean, are you asking how much do I feed? So when I'm breeding them, I overfeed like crazy and do lots of water changes. When I don't want them to breed, I probably feed like every other day. Nope, sorry Bob, your imagination is what psychologists classify as mentally insane in the membrane. Don't worry, Aqua, Bob is getting so used to skipping his mod's random comments, but we will try to answer. Just type the question again, I'll try to answer. Yep, that's what I got mods for. So they can answer the questions I skip. Now I gotta go and see. They always say I skip questions, and then I scroll all the way back up and I still don't see it. So I don't see anything from Aqua. And this is going back like 10 minutes. Zach's Tank's Crazy Aquarium Guy says, what is the best LED light you have, Bob? Probably the Phoenix Ray 2. I really like that one. Tropical Tanker says, what's the background tank? Probably already been asked, but I forgot. You mean like, whose is it? Or like, what is it? Like, what kind of fish? Bob, you can control F to find comments. Yeah, but I don't want to work that hard. I'm not getting paid here, so I'm not working that hard. Not anymore. Lucas was making it rain, but it's not raining anymore. So I'm not working that hard. Hey Bob, do you ever share your screen while on Aquabid? I don't think I've ever been on Aquabid while live streaming. Bob, didn't you say that Phoenix Raid 2s are garbage? Nope. That's not what I said. Gotta pay attention. Short, nice hashtag. I'm getting hashtag now. North Wales Zoo says, any thoughts on Seachem Flourish? It's a good low light fertilizer. Is Bob on Aquabid? Yep, you can find me on Aquabid, though I haven't sold anything for a very long time. I don't think I've sold anything on Aquabid since I started YouTubing. Trouble Taker says, whose tank is it and what's in there? Oh, so both then. So this tank is Gribble, Grimble, Grumble's tank, and those are Melanotania garrylangi, blue pearl shrimp, even though they're looking awfully white, and some sort of rasbora in there. I think that's all I see right now. Like pork chop rasbora, maybe? I don't know. Let's see. What's up, shrimp tank people? Crystal Bob's Ball says, Bob, since you work IT and all that good stuff, ever consider making a nano aquarium out of a monitor? No, because all the monitors are like a half an inch thick now. I don't think I could find a CRT monitor if my life depended on it. Alex says, I flew a helicopter to pick up my arowana for the second time. Bob, look this up. I think you'll like it. Show the people a picture of it. Black banded rainbow fish. There, see now if you give scientific names instead of your crazy Canadian common names. Let's see. Oops. I wouldn't say it's the most colorful rainbow fish, but it's got a good body structure. Finally made a live stream while it's happening. Well, that's good, Kevin. It's almost over, but Cristobal says, I didn't even consider that. You were right. You sounded like Dustin when you said that. That's because he was typing like Dustin. What's up, shrimp tank people? I don't think I sounded like Dustin though. That was not a very good Dustin impersonation. iPod's dead. Stop the workout for a moment. Stupid question. Anyone have a brand of super glue or recommend for gluing Java Moss? The only thing you need to know about that is it has to be super glue gel. That's it. It can be any brand. Just make sure that it's the gel. Hey Bob, can you use the background I sent you next live stream, please? There's a list of like 20. And I still have to download it. I did watch it. When I was watching it, it wasn't in high def. So hopefully when I download it, it'll be in high def. But it has to be high def. I don't know, Bob. Out of all the rainbows, I still prefer a good quality Bosmani. Yeah, they're nice. Anthony's got to go. Pro tip for Java Moss is use a hairnet. That is a pro tip. That's a pro tip for any moss, though, really. Nisi says, thank you, Bob. Yeah, no problem. Did I miss anything? Level one mods. Ooh, a deleted message. Let's see what it got deleted. More coffins. Yeah, not sure what the deal with that is. Pro tip taken. Oh wow, I did not realize that there was that. What? Oh wow, I did not realize there was that many. I filmed it in 1080p. Well, like I said, it could be a lot better when I actually download it. I'll probably do that. Well, I have till Saturday, so Fish Tropic says, "I'm so sorry, Bob. Not sure what you're apologizing for. You crazy Americans." Yeah. Let's see. Typical Corey, always wanting to teach. Fish Tropic, LOL. Thank you, Corey. What is DFT? I don't know. Filthy Phil says, "Did my background video come through okay?" Nope. Still has not worked for me. Whatever like website you're using does not work for me at all. And it kind of pisses me off because I really want to see it. Short Anxious, it's Dustin's Fish Tank. Oh, DFT, Dustin's Fish Tank. Bummer, I will try again. You got to try it a different way because that website is bogus. I think it's trying to force me to make an account, and I'm not going to make an account. Well, let me know if it works, because it does not, I can refilm it and make it better. I know you were panned out quite a bit, but if I use your video, there's going to be a lot of blacks. There's going to be like a black bar that goes like right across here. Like the bottom inch is going to be all black. So you might want to get in closer and make sure there is no like border. But I haven't downloaded it yet, so I don't know. Oh, well, I thought people were misspelling DTF. Joel, this hill is so infamous. I want to drone this hill to show everyone. Best combo, Chef Boyardee and livestream. Bob, why you no have pictures of rainbows on Instagram? That's a good question. I don't think I do. I don't think I've even posted a photo for like a week. Bob, check this one out. Yeah, I've seen that one. I used to have it. The Splendida Inornata. I used to keep those. I want to roll down the hill. DTF, LOL. Just to let you guys know, we're only going until 8:30 tonight. Because I still got to edit tomorrow's video. R2 says, "I like cichlids." So do I. What's a good floating plant to keep with goldfish? I don't know. I think they would probably eat just about anything. Yeah, Lucas, he didn't get the whole intro, but he got some of it. But he didn't get the bringing it to you on a Sunday, baby. How's it going? I am doing well. Yeah. He missed some of it. Bob, I think you'd like my Instagram. I have a bunch of pictures of my rainbows, that photobomb my angels. Cheeky wankers. They did eat a lot of floating plants, but mine never ate crystal wort. Bob, go check out Aquarium of Cichlids channel. You got tricked again. Where has my life gone? I'm not gonna lie, I almost fell for that. I almost did. But then I looked at your name. Lucas also forgot to flail his arms. I got the arm flail, right? Bob, what do you think of the new iPad cameras and the new iPad camera, that's what you use to film in the background? I don't know. I don't do anything Apple, so I don't know anything about it. Apple sucks. Dan says, "I do love Dustin's enthusiasm." Hopefully it doesn't piss him off. Imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, right? Grapes. I feel like I'd be the easiest to intimidate. Because he just gotta go like this. Yeah, okay, let's talk about fish. There's my impersonation of me. Bob, you should attend your live stream with an outrageous wig on one day. I'm just glad D didn't go all Fingazi on Lucas like he did on Corey. Maybe he just hasn't seen it yet. He probably doesn't know who Lucas is. No one can get mad at Fish Tank Jesus. Yeah, that's true. Bob, I love you. Happy Valentine's. Well, happy Valentine's to you too. Joey has the biggest YouTube channel dedicated to our hobby. Who is the second biggest? Probably Dustin. Is there Dustin's at 90. Is there anyone over 90? Hey Bob, do you have a salt meter? Yep, I have a refractometer. R2 just woke up. I don't know why I did that. Burning Fyra, yep. I'm pretty sure I already agreed to be burning Fyra's Valentine's after Gian turned me down. LOL, Bob, just say oops, whoops, and scientific names mess ups. See, I edit all that out. I do all that stuff, but I try to edit it out. I already look like enough of an idiot. R2 says, do you think I can win the challenge? What challenge? Taylor has 210,000. Yeah, that's not a fish channel though. That's a pet channel. May have answered, got any kills? Kills? Not since Nom. Dustin has more subscribers, but I think Corey has more of a presence. I don't know. I just got some new fish yesterday and I'm so pumped. Four female cherry barbs and one male swordtail. Yeah, I don't know what challenge you're talking about. The only challenge I know of is the daily video challenge. LOL, it makes your video more personal and so funny. I love watching your videos. Uh-oh. What are we talking about? I think by kills he means. Interesting. Moderator is about to get demoted. Come on, moderators. Dustin, it's hard for me to watch. I get stressed out with all his yelling. You just gotta turn down the volume a little, that's all. Killifish, I meant. Yes, I have killifish, but I'm so bad at killifish, I don't even know what their names are. Quarrymacyclic says mods, not cool to let that comment pass. Yeah, where's my mods? Oh, am I gonna have to actually do something here? Where did that go? There it is. Making me work, doing my own work. Guess it's time to find more mods. Yeah, I put the mods to sleep. Maybe that's my own fault. Mod's not gonna get that. Yep. No, you forced me to get another mod. There you go. Now, which mod do I gotta fire to make room for the new mod? Claw says, I got no space in the house. What's your thoughts on setting up a fish room in a 40-foot shipping container? I think that would be awesome. I've always wanted a shipping container. Always. Yeah, Andrew Lee, I have two different types of killifish, and honestly, I don't know what types they are. I volunteer as tribute. Yeah, whiskey's the only mod that doesn't have to do anything. Everyone else, though, you gotta pay attention. Vincent says, hello, my Molly just had a large batch of fry. They have not eaten any of the fry and it's been days. Ooh, excuse me. There's a ton of them. Should I move them into another tank? As long as you keep the adults well fed, you shouldn't have to worry about it. Well, I have to call it. My baby won't stop crying. Night all. Okay, that's an acceptable excuse. It's 8:30 anyway, so it's time to close the live stream. You're fired. Honestly, I don't talk about politics on my channel, but I really wanted to see Trump go in and just be like, you're fired, just like on the TV show. That would have been sweet. Charles says, Bob, last time I literally answered every single question while you played Overwatch. That's true. That's true. But alright guys, I gotta call it a night. I gotta edit tomorrow's video. That's an hour and a half though. That went by pretty quick. And I think, don't hold me to it, but I might stream again on Thursday. But if not Thursday, definitely my normal time. Saturday at 5 p.m. Pacific. Daily videos. Tomorrow's video, I'm tearing down a 33 gallon to make room for a 55 gallon. So definitely check that out. And I don't think I have any other news for you. Definitely check out Corey's channel. I don't know when my fish room tour video is coming out, but definitely look out for that because that'll be really cool. And Zach's Tanks Crazy Aquarium Guy is my channel of the day, so that'll be in tomorrow's video as well. Yeah, that's it. Thanks, everyone, and I'll.